I told you, how many times do I want to tell you to get out of here?
Inside watching my baby.
I'm doing my homework. I left the doors open.
You've got some nerve just barging in here. You got knuckles. Knock.
Paige, you sit and watch my baby.
Your two lousy bucks don't buy my daughter forever.
I paid the kid to watch the baby.
Well, what's all the noise about?
You get out of here, Adolph, dressed like that in front of this.
This what, Ida? Come on, you know the word. Say it.
And you get out of here, Miss Lena Harris.
Yeah, well, when I pay Lucille to sit with my baby, she better sit with my baby. You hear?
Or what? Tell me, or what? I'm her mother. Legitimate, I'm her mother. I tell her. She does what I tell her. And now, goodbye. Get out, scat.
Goodbye.
Cover up your fat pot before she...
What? He should live so long. Telling you now, Mrs. Kopacek, that if you ever pull that again, I'm going to come in here and I'm going to turn the place upside down. That's all.
I'll tell him here, will you?
Sure.
Now stick it in. The gut. That's right, in the chest. Out. Way out. Good. Now what do you say, Paco?
Oh, morning, Neil. Mrs. Pellegrino, this is Mr. Neil Brock, my associate.
You do?
Pleasure, I'm sure. Mrs. Pellegrino is concerned about it, about her grandchild. Suppose you tell Mr. Brock the story, Mrs. Pellegrino.
She goes with men for money.
She?
The mother. Lena Harris.
This is your daughter-in-law?
She's nobody's daughter-in-law. Joey, my son, is not a husband. He met this Lena Harris a couple of years ago, and he got around to see her. Big things, big romance. Big thing, till she got the baby and she made them say that it belonged to Joey.
Made who say?
The court.
There was a paternity suit?
Whatever you call it. You see, my Joey, He's like me. He's nervous. And after the court, he go away.
Where to?
I don't know. Just went away, that's all. He used to run away sometime when he was younger. Once he went to Bear Mountains for a whole day. Once he went to Pennsylvania to my sister's, so far. And just don't seem to grow up, my Joe.
And I get this straight, Miss Pellegrino. Your son left the city as soon as the court established he was the father, is that right?
Just went away.
Well, where is he now?
I don't know.
Well, does it concern you that he deserted it?
This girl is no Italian.
Mrs. Pellegrino, do you want this baby? Would you be willing to take care of it?
Well, I think so.
But you're not sure, huh?
It's just that for me to take care of him, I don't know. You see, I'm not so young no more. I got a pretty small place by myself. And to tell you the truth, I don't know if they allow it for me to take a baby away from its mother.
The court allows it. If the mother is found unfit.
The court? But I don't like the courts. I don't like the scandal, the fuss. I'm 59 years old.
This is a family kind of court. A very simple hearing is held in a case like this.
And from what do they hear? From papers I gotta go and sign?
A petition, yeah. Oh. A petition against the mother is necessary first. Now, we can originate it, or it can be originated by the SPCC.
SPCC?
The Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Children.
Or, of course, by you. Now, the judge sits and listens to the petition, and if he rules that the petition is valid, he'll remand the child to a potential guardian, if there is one, or to a shelter.
Oh, I don't like that. A shelter for the baby. Oh, that sounds indecent when there's relatives. No.
All right, I'll tell you what let's do. I'll go and see this, Miss Harris, shall I? You wouldn't mind that, and the baby. And I'll look the situation over for myself, and I'll be in a better position to suggest what you might do.
Please, you know about these things so much. These big words, these cases, more than me, you know. And maybe after you go to see this girl, you talk to him, maybe you... You can come and tell me what I should do. Because you see, these years, you get old and you don't know what to do no more. One thing only for sure, you know, there's a God in heaven, that's all. The other things of life, you don't know nothing no more. Please, Mr. Brooke. I don't know how to turn. Talk to this Lena Harris. Go see for yourself.
Oh, Mr. Bry.
Hi, Emily.
Don't bother pushing any of those bells. They haven't worked since World War I.
How are you?
Fine, thanks.
There's a bruiser here.
Oh, well, thanks.
Hey, how's Charlie?
Oh, he's fine. Much better, thanks to you. He's working good now, and his temper's cooled down. Knock wood. Did you come by to see Charlie?
No, I'm looking for Elena Harris.
Oh, yeah. Sure. Third floor, right over me.
You know her? What's she like?
I know where to see her, but friendly, no. Oh, gee, I hope there's no trouble for her, though. I mean, you know, everybody's always talking about her. You know, about the men. Some of them even say she don't bring up her baby right. Like, because she never takes it down in a carriage, you know, for the son, like all the other mothers. Well, I say, gee whiz, we don't know all the facts of her situation. Who are we to judge?
Very nice person, Emily.
Look who's talking. You know what I think? I think Lena Harris isn't half as bad as they say she is.
Rock?
Rock?
Rock.
Oh. Gee, I thought you said Rock.
Well, I guess that's your disappointment for the day, huh?
Who sent you? Nobody comes here. No, this is where I live, not where I work.
No, I'd like to have a talk with you, if I may.
Oh, brother, you're one of those. Mr., you want a listener? I know a girl named Flory. She's got big eyes, big ears, big everything. Over there on Third
Avenue. I'm from the Community Welfare Service.
Oh. Where's your tambourine?
May I come in?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
You're a social worker?
Uh-huh.
No braid.
Am I?
Most of them I've seen got as much juice as an index card. Sit down.
Thank you. I had a talk this morning with Mrs. Frances Pellegrino.
Oh, you did? I bet you cried. And cried and cried. How long did it take you to dry out?
She seems worried about your baby.
She's worried about my baby. Why doesn't she worry about her own baby, Joey? Joey Pellegrino. After all, he's only the father of my son. You're my son, Mr. Brock. It's all I've got. It's all I've ever had. So you keep your hands off if that's what you've come here to talk about.
As a matter of fact, that's exactly why I'm here. This woman came into our office with a complaint. And if it becomes official, you could lose your baby.
What? Says who?
Well, the law might say.
The law? Mr. Brock, don't talk to me about the law. Oh, sure, when I proved that Joey was the father of my son, the court ordered him to pay me once a week to help support the kid. Well, then Joey flew the coop without giving me a cent. Where's the law then?
I'd like to see the baby.
What, for the big report you're going to have to make out? Why don't you ask the neighbors? They'd be glad to tell you all about him. How I mistreat him, how I never take him out. You know, the kind of thing they make sure I hear whenever I'm out in front of my door. You know, there goes a Mr. Harris. Go ask her how a kid is, Mr. Harris. Or her, if it wasn't for her, poor Joey Pellegrino wouldn't have gotten so upset and had to go away. Oh, he's such a sheep, Joey. Such a handsome, promising boy, huh? And if it wasn't for her, he would have married one of our daughters, and then the whole lousy neighborhood would have been happy.
May I see the baby?
Sure. Then there was a dungeon where the wicked princess lived, and chained to the crib was a poor baby.
Very nice.
Thanks to Macy's.
You pay for this yourself?
Mm-hmm.
It's a fancy looking gizmo there.
Well, my kid gets his son, vital indeed, just like any other kid. It's like his mother used to when she was playing Mary Model.
Oh, you modeled, huh?
I used to. For a while there, I was even queen of the calendars. That's the kind you find in your neighborhood garage. I had higher aims than that, though. When I came to this town, I wanted to be a high fashion gal. You know, the kind that goes around carrying those little round suitcases all over. Takes taxi cabs all over. I had $60 an hour just for standing there in Christian Dior dresses. Dreams. I sleep tight.
What happened?
What happened?
Oh, you come to this town, you meet a photographer. He says, kid, you're not starved enough looking for this high fashion stuff. Well, you stick with me, all won't be lost. So you stick with him, and you start with the detective magazines. And then you go to the love stories. And then, because time passes and they start to treat you like you are a hag already, some Lenslaus says you want to pose for the girlies. That's how it starts. That's how you get hooked. So all of a sudden, that phone starts to ring. Strangers, all kinds of guys start to call you. You hang up, of course. Except one fine day, you find yourself in, shall we say, a peculiar predicament. You got a kid to support, and a guy you really counted on walked out on you. You need money. You don't hang up anymore. You see, Mr. Brock, I do what I do. Not because I like it, but because of the quick cash. It's the loot. More loot than I can make any other way. What? What I do is bad? Well, who says it isn't? But it helps to support me and the kid. And it helps to pay the bills. And oh boy, do those bills pile up. I pay them, you know. I pay every one of them. I mean, you see my baby's furniture? That's paid for. And the hospital that my baby was born in, that's paid for, too. Even the dozen yellow roses that I sent myself in the hospital because I couldn't stand smelling everybody else's roses. Well, that's paid. It's paid. Everything's paid.
I think we're beginning to upset the baby,
man. I think we're beginning to upset me. Mr. Brock, will you please go?
Here's my card. It has our office address and my phone number on it.
But I don't want your card. I don't want any help from you at all. Will you please go?
They outgrow these things, huh?
Hey, my little Billy, he's got so many things he's outgrown. Would you like it if, maybe I brought some of them up sometime? You could see if you could use them.
No sense letting the moths get through them.
Yeah, maybe sometime.
Okay. Look, my name's Emily. What's yours?
Lena.
It's gorgeous.
It's exotic for Elaine. Made it up myself.
Can I try it on?
Yeah, how do you do it?
This way?
How do I look?
Nice.
Look, Ma, I am Gina Lola Bridget Hart.
Huh?
Lena. Lena, did you get along all right with Mr. Brock before?
Well, I thought there was some kind of a catch in this, huh?
No catch, honest. Look, no. It's just that... Well, if there's going to be trouble for you, I just hope you agreed to let Mr. Brock help you, that's all. I mean, he's a nice guy. He's sure been helping me and my Charlie. Well, Lena, look, if I was your own sister, I couldn't give you better advice than just give him a chance, at least, and talk to him some more. I mean, if there is trouble that's going to be started about you and about your baby here.
Yeah, well, there's not going to be any trouble about me or my baby, all right?
Hope not. I better finish the wash. There's just no end to it, is there?
It's such a shame I can't go outside and look at people.
Frances, you gotta do something about the baby. She'll ruin him sure enough, that one next door.
But it's our baby.
Yeah, but it's your grandchild. Look, we've been friends a long time. I gotta be honest with you. You gotta do something about the baby.
But what? What? Tell me.
You take him.
From the mother?
Some mother. Who are we kidding?
Oh, but without no husband. Without no Joe here no more.
You'll pardon me for pointing it out to you, but whose fault is it Joey ran away? Hers, right?
Right. Do I know what's right?
This where you save lost souls?
No, that's just down the block. Big place, got a cross on top if you can't miss it.
Can I sit down?
Sure.
I bet you didn't think I'd come.
Well, I hoped you might.
Well, actually, I just dropped by to ask you a question.
Okay, go ahead.
Do you think I neglect my baby? No, you saw. You saw the room I have for him and how clean it is and the toys. I buy special baby food for him. Yeah, whenever I go out, I always make sure there's a babysitter. You know, everything. I mean, can anybody say I neglect that kid?
Well, what do you care, Lena? I mean, sticks and stones. Are you worried about what people say or think about you?
No, couldn't care less.
Why bring it up?
Well, because I was talking to this fellow, lawyer, and he said that the only time that they can take a baby away from its mother is if they can prove that the mother's neglecting the kid. Is that right?
That's about right, yeah.
Well, I got nothing to worry about, right?
No, wrong.
Yeah, but you saw it.
I saw, I saw a clean room and a fat little baby.
Well?
Well, how long do you suppose a person in your profession can sustain that?
What do you mean by that?
I'm not going to go beyond that. I don't think I have to.
Yeah, well, you sure do. I mean, you make a crack like that, you better go beyond it.
No. You asked me a question, I gave you an answer. Yes, you do have something to worry about.
Yeah, well, that... I mean, I come in here like you asked me to, and right away, you... As soon as I say anything, you make a dig, right? A remark, a moral judgment.
I think I'm being slightly misquoted.
Oh, yeah, listen to him.
Come on, come on, sit down, let's talk.
No, I'll tell you what I'd like to see. I'd like to see one sign that you or anybody else gives a hoot and hell about somebody like me. Yeah, somebody like me who's willing to give everything she's got, and I mean everything she's got, just so she can bring up the baby the best she can.
All right. I guess I owe you an apology. I didn't mean it to sound snide, what I said.
Yeah.
You know, This place is like a port where everybody's troubles come to anchor. I sit over there listening. And for some reason or other, people seem to think I have a pat answer, some kind of quick remedy for their troubles. I don't have it. And it gets to me sometimes, and I say something I shouldn't say. Okay, that proves I'm human.
Proves you're a jerk.
Which makes me not only human, but lovable. What do you say we change the subject?
What?
You.
Doll, let's go for another.
No, you. You got any family?
Nope. I kicked around some relatives before I was able to work my own way.
Doing what?
What is this, true confessions?
Save me buying next month's issue.
All right, surprise. I wanted to be an actress. That was my first ambition, even before modeling. I had stars in my eyes, so I headed for Hollywood.
Did you make it?
I made Round Lake, Idaho. Now, there was this summer theater there. Finally landed a part. Lead. I played a dying girl. So by the time that I died on opening night, there were a dozen people left in the theater. Yeah, but I said to myself, hey, you're not going to die without anybody watching. I mean, I expected a lot of applause for the scene, you know, a packed house. There were only a dozen people left. Because, I mean, one by one, they'd all walked out of me. And can you imagine dying alone? Me? Uh-uh. When I die, I want standing room only. So that was the end of my acting career, because I turned right around and I went east and I modeled and met Joey Pellegrino. Mr. Brock, will you help me, please?
I'll try. But in the long run, whatever help you get has to come from yourself.
I want my baby.
I know that, and I believe it. But you're doing everything you can to lose him. You must know that.
What can I do?
Jobs around, lots of jobs. So the first thing we've got to do is check into job opportunities. And the second thing is the baby. Now, there are all sorts of ways that he can be looked after during the day by very competent people and reasonably. So we'll look into that. And the third thing, I suggest you get into a new neighborhood, new environment. Now, Jane Foster's our crackerjack apartment hunter. She'll help you there. If you're really with the idea, Lena.
That's Emily Mooney with her.
I got into Emily anyway.
That's Emily's carriage. The other one's pushing, ain't it?
Yeah. I had my husband bring it up from the cellar for her.
How do you like that?
Hello. Beautiful day, isn't it?
Beautiful. Yeah. Now, but I better be going upstairs now.
Hi. It's early yet. Come on, sit down for a while.
Your chairs?
This one's mine. That's Mrs. Cogan's. Second floor rear, and she won't mind.
I think Miss Cogan's coming back soon, Emily. What? Ice cream.
Hi.
Hello.
How's Adolf?
Who knows?
He's
got his head in a ball game as usual. The Mets. That's Mrs. Cogan's chair, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's Mrs. Cogan's chair, so what?
I was just noticing is all.
What's going on here? Is this Buckingham Palace, is it?
Shh. Hey, that's Charlie. He's home early. Charlie, honey. Look, I want you to meet me.
I know who she is. What in the hell are you doing with her?
Billy, honey. Baby, look who's home. It's Daddy, baby.
This is Billy's carriage, isn't it?
It's the one he used to use, yeah.
What is she doing with it?
I let it to her, so.
Oh, you did. Big-hearted you.
Lombardi's, the Thompsons. Can't read my own writing.
Can I help you?
Tommy Morgan. How are you?
Good to see you, Neil.
Good to see you. Good to see you. Let's knock off tonight. Huh?
Okay.
Thank you. Well, you look well.
I'm fine. Fine.
So that's a beauty you got there. Good night, dear. Thank you. Yeah. Sit down, sit down.
It's been a long time.
Yeah, you still live in the... Where was that you were living?
Dobbs Ferry. No. Oh, I'm back. I was born in this city. I'm inured to this city. You take away the soot and the grime and the occasional smells, and I start to get sick. I come down with all kinds of things. Neil, I dropped by to talk to you about a Lena Harris.
Well, I had a hunch. How'd you find out about it?
Well, I got a call from Mrs. Kopacek,
yeah.
Neighbor of hers. And I called Mrs. Pellegrino.
And she told you that I was looking into it. Huh?
Yes. Now, Neil, I don't want to cross lines here, but if what those women told me is true, or even partly true. Well, I've got to have a look into this thing.
Sure.
What kind of a girl is she?
Well, she's got her problems.
That kind of answer I could get from my wife.
How is she anyway?
Laura? I sent her to visit with her mother for a couple weeks.
So she could get some more good answers.
Yeah, from an expert.
tell me. Well, about this Lena Harris thing, you don't want to cross lines, neither do I. I'm telling you right now, you're going to find yourself in a darling dilemma right here. Question. You take a child away from its natural mother because society says that the mother is morally unfit, even though the mother is bringing love and affection and tender care to the child. You take the child, Tommy? You snatch him out of his cradle, you throw him in that jungle out there with the strange hands, strange faces? I don't know the answer, do you?
You know the law.
Oh, yeah, I know the law. But the law can mean what you and the judge want it to mean. I don't wear a badge, so I permit myself the luxury of looking beyond the law, way out to a girl the law forgot. Lena Harris.
You think she's getting a raw deal?
I know she's getting the raw deal. The law decided that Joey Pellegrino was the father, huh? And the law ordered him to support the child. But Joey took a powder. Joey flew the coop. And now is the law going to make good on Joey? Hell no.
She could apply for relief.
Yeah, she could, but she hasn't. She's found her own way. Some places, they'd call this initiative, private enterprise, rugged individualism. Now, maybe it's just pride, who knows?
So she came to you for help. So?
Well, nothing brilliant. New job, maybe a new apartment. Ingenious, huh?
Something about her has caught you, hasn't it?
Yeah, something about her has caught me. Hooked me. Well, I think she's an all right kid. I think there's more good than bad in her. That's why I wouldn't want to be in your shoes, buddy. Not for $1 million. You figure out the case. Society versus Lena Harris.
Oh, pardonnez-moi, Wilcox.
Hey, you are from Rochester, Massachusetts.
No, New York.
Well, listen, Willis. Matt, now I want you to take a look around this hall of mirrors.
Oh, nice mirrors. Nice and bright and shiny.
Cousin, I want you to meet the King of France. It's King Freddy.
Hey, come on, Lucille. You're the littlest cousin of them all.
Get back in there.
Back in your trough with the rest of the pigs, eh? And to the guillotine with you, and with you,
and you,
and you. If I can find a knife that'll cut through that fat, greasy neck of yours.
I'm gonna call the cops.
Oh, Freddy, strike up La Marseillaise. Strike up the Marseillaise.
Cops, man.
Freddy, strike up the Marseillaise. Allons enfants de la patrie.
Oh, hey, look who's here. It's Brock Hudson is our living breed. Who's that with you, Brock, all right? Huh? Oh, don't tell me. I know who that is. That's Marlo Holden.
Marlo Holden.
Well, come on in. Come on in, gentlemen. I think it's very nice of you to drop by.
Good night, ladies. Want a drink?
Where's the baby?
Shh, 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 shh.
Baby's
sleeping.
Don't you have a sitter for him?
Yeah, I got a sitter. He's sitting somewhere else, though. Right there. Your friend looks like he's okay. Why don't you tell the friend to stick around after all the fun's just started?
This friend is from the SPCC.
I wouldn't care if he was from the IMB or IBM or FLR or DM.
I don't know whether I can get through to you or not, through all that woo. But it may interest you to know that I think you've blown the whole deal. I think you've kicked everything you love right out the...
Don't blame her.
Doesn't matter whether I blame her or not, Emily. I'm afraid she's tossed away every chance she had of keeping her baby.
Mr. Brock, you don't know what happened to her. Look, she tried. She tried. She really... Please, you've
got... Forget it.
No, listen. You've got to listen to me. Look, this afternoon, we took the babies out walking together. We got back. The whole scummy crew around here moved in on her like a pack of vultures. Oh, yeah, and Charlie. My own sweet Charlie. Practically took my head off just because I let her use the carriage. He picked her baby up out of that and he threw it at her, her baby. Like it was something foul. Well, how do you think she felt? Come on, how would you feel? That's why she did this, and I don't blame her. And not you, not anyone else has the right to judge her. Listen, you want to know who to blame? I'll tell you who to blame. Big Nose Malloy. And Kopacek. Well, a rat trap where her heart ought to be. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can include that crybaby grandmother of Joey's.
Boy, she has been a tower of nothing.
You're going, aren't you? I guess this is the best solution. I think it is, anyway.
I know you do.
It's not my decision, Neil. The way it'll be decided, though. Face it. There've been other cases like this. Not many, but a few. What will happen is inevitable. The witnesses, the neighbors will testify. Tom Morgan will have to say he saw what happened in the apartment that night. The judge will listen. Fact is, Neil, the girl is a
prostitute. An untouchable. A pariah. No sympathy, no compassion.
Oh, Neil.
You know, the thing I can never, never, never understand. The female heart. You weep for thieves and murderers. And when one of your own sets a price tag on herself, down comes the axe.
That is uncalled for.
Is it not?
I have as much pity for the girl as you have. But I'm afraid my main concern is for the child. And you know, and I know, that if the child is kept with the mother, it'll be scarred for life.
And taking it away from the mother, what's that going to do to it, huh? That's going to just give it a little bruise, huh? A little minor contusion. Put cold compresses on it, and everything's going to be A-OK, huh?
So that's $3.30
coffee.
You
got it, ma'am.
Okay. How's the baby?
Oh, nice and quiet. I gave him his lunch, then I put him to bed, and right off he went. That's a good baby you've got there.
Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Funny, funny, funny. You know, when I saw that judge, I thought he looked like a kind man. I thought he'd be for me. I thought he'd tell Ida Kovacek to go take a flying leap for herself. Didn't.
Isn't the end of the world, you know. The judge just gave temporary custody of the baby to Mrs. Pellegrino. You could get your baby back if...
If what? I proved that I'm a fit mother for the baby. You think that anybody asked the baby? Or maybe the baby has some doubts.
Well, that's all up to you. That's all I can say.
Yeah.
Better if I get him. All right?
Dad, all right.
Hey.
It ain't easy. I'm gonna have to get a crib for the baby and put her in the bedroom. The bedroom is so small as it is.
Mrs. Pellegrino, the baby likes strained peas. Best of all, it likes strained peas. And, it's bottle. Don't warm the milk too much because it'll just take that bottle and it'll toss it. I mean, if you have any good lamps that are around the house, you better put them in storage because he just tosses bottles. And, diaper rash. He is very prone to diaper rash and he gets very uncomfortable if you don't change him right away. He cries. But you'll get used to that sound. And, in about 3 months, he has to be taken to the doctors for a polio shot. Now, you remember that, Mrs. Pellegrino. It's a booster. Well, that's all.
Was a lovely man. He was refined. He was smart. He was everything you expect a judge to be like. And when they put me on the witness stand and I had to tell them about some of the things that we saw going on, you know, with that one upstairs. Well, hello, Francis.
Hi.
How did things go upstairs?
Very
hard. You know, what was done was good. It was just and it was lawful. You know, with trash like that one upstairs, well, you've done the right thing, Mr. Brock.
Don't mention it, Mrs. Kopacek. Who knows? Tomorrow I may be able to help you.